God's glory in the heavens. The reverence of Jehovah is the beginning of wisdom. Only the foolish say in their heart, there is no God. Day unto day uttereth speech, and night unto night showeth knowledge. The heavens declare the glory of God. An appreciation of the infinite power of the Creator and of our own littleness should make us teachable. The study of creation is the key of knowledge. Using this key, we begin to realize that the only worthy ambition is to cooperate with our Creator's beneficent designs respecting His creation. The planets of our system, compared with our sun, are as nothing. Imagine the sun's diameter, that of a large flour barrel. Jupiter would compare as a small orange, Earth and Venus as peas, and Mercury and Mars as raspberry seeds. The sun is 300,000 times the size of our Earth. A train at 30 miles an hour could go around the Earth in 1 month, but nearly 10 years would be required for it to travel the circumference of the sun. Our day and night are the result of the Earth's rotation on its own axis, while its motion around the sun marks our year. Planets nearer the sun have shorter orbits and hence shorter years, while remote ones have longer years. A year on the planet Mercury would equal 3 of our months. On Neptune, farthest off, a year equals 164 of Earth's years. Yet our sun is only one of the fixed stars, of which the most up-to-date astronomical methods estimate there are 125 million. Around each of these fixed stars undoubtedly revolves a planetary system like our own. Thus reckoned, there are 1,000 million worlds. Even this is not the limit. If we should stand upon the farthest and dimmest star, we should no doubt from there see as many more beyond. We are appalled at the greatness of the universe. The zodiacal signs illustrate various sections of the heavens visible at different seasons.